Well, hello guys. I have no idea what the hell I am playing. A long time ago, I saw this game with a friend of mine, and we watched like 2 minutes on YouTube. So I guess the point is to listen to what the narrator tells you, and you can pretty much choose your own path from there. But it's supposed to be a really weird, like, mind fuck of a game. So we're gonna play it. All right. This should be a big ol' fun time. Oh yeah.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427
No, we're just gonna. Oh, okay. Well, this is great. Well, look at that. The situation unfuckled itself. Okay, so from what I got by that really laggy cutscene was that Stanley's number was 427. He pushed buttons all day. Nobody's coming in to tell him what buttons to push, so he's going to talk to his boss.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
I'm sorry about that, guys. I just installed this game.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Nah.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Ah, yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
I really do not like that. I don't like this frame skip. I don't know what's causing it.
Really worth it, being here in the room. A room so utterly captivating that even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings. Really worth it.
Okay.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Yeah, we'll do the main story first. Alright.
And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
Okay, can't let my ADD get the best of me.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Using slides to assure employees that everything is okay, make sure you slide the slick blue graphic in the header and throw some bevel on the text to ensure a calm and productive work environment. Wow, really? Everyone is unique. Most of all. Wow, alright. Broom closet. Sitting here for a little bit.
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
Okay.
There was nothing here. No choice to make, no path to follow, just an empty broom closet. No reason to still be here.
I kind of want to stay now that he said... Alright, you know what?
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
I really don't want to do any of this. Oh, that's the executive bathroom. I don't know what's going on with my recording.
Stepping into his manager's office. And it was once again since to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this, what dark secret was being held from him. What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845.
Right.
But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keyboard, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passage situation.
Whoa. Yeah, I'm sorry for that voice skip, guys. You know what? I'll fix it right now, actually. Alright. That didn't fix it at all. In fact, that made it worse. Okay, I'll be right back. You know, I honestly think recording the footage slows down my PC, because when I'm not recording, the game runs like butter. Two seconds. Fuck it, we're trudging forward. At a snail's pace. I'm trying so hard. Okay, I'm gonna fix this. I'll get back to you guys in a second. Boop! Well, I mean, that helped a little, but fuck it. You guys are gonna have to deal with it. I've tried. I've noticed a pattern in a lot of my videos. It takes a minute. Usually it runs fine. It ran Undertale just fine, recording or not. It runs a few games just fine, whether I'm recording or not. It's just very confusing, I guess, to work with. I don't know. We'll do the main story, and then we'll fuck around a little bit. This game takes forever to load.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long.
Stanley
walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility. Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley Way would meet his violent death.
Gonna throw that card in my face, aren't ya?
But of course, Stanley thought all better of it, and realized ISTT simply had too much to live for.
What a dick!
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Pity he had the strength to find out. Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Whoa. You know, I really wish I could fucking enjoy this game at a full fucking FPS rate. Sorry.
This is mind control facility. It was too horrible to believe it could be true. Had Andy maybe been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept him blindly? No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never! It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world? But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or contented. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life.
Yeah, I'm sorry about this, guys. I'm trying to fix it. But I'm just going to go with it because...
For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Whoa.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
What happened? What happened?
Blackness and a rising chill of uncertainty. Was it open? Yes. He had won. He had defeated the machine. Unshackled himself from someone else's command. Freedom was mere moments away. And yet, even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many puzzles still lay unsolved. Where had his co-workers gone? How had he been freed from the machine's grasp?
Wow. I really love this lag, guys.
He realized none of this mattered to him. For it was not knowledge or even power that he had been seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go. No longer would anyone tell him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever life he lives, it will be his. And that was all he needed to know. It was, perhaps, the only thing worth knowing. Stanley stepped through the open door. S-
You know, I would have probably enjoyed that more if everything wasn't super glitchy and laggy, but, I mean, it was a good story. It was pretty good, yeah. I liked that. I really did. I enjoyed that. Now we're going to completely disobey the narrator and see what we can get away with. Alright.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. When Stanley came to a set of two...
Eat a dick.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Wow. Yes. This room. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
No, I didn't, bitch.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've got Bob on the wrong foot here. I realize that you're in someone else's business, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
You guys hate that when, like, you were a little kid and, like, your disc skipped?
There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for Helen.
What?
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life.
What?
She's been waiting.
Whoa.
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this. To reach out to her.
What the fuck? Who's her? What am I doing? What?
Hold on, please. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the fryer out of the oven.
What?
Alright. Okay, there we go. Alright now. I want you to come in and tell me all about
your day like this. Gotcha. Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife who'd want to commit their life to you?
What?
I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something. Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
Okay. Hi, honey.
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stan.
Okay, I want to leave. Good morning. Okay, press G on your keyboard.
Stanley is quite a boring fellow. He has a job that demands nothing of him. And every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence. Look at him in there, pushing buttons, doing it exactly what he's just told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now he's eating lunch. Now he's going home. Now he's coming back to work. One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life. But in his mind, In his mind, he can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown. Fantastic discoveries of new lands. It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him. And so he began to fantasize about his own job. First, he imagined that one day while at work, he stepped out from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building had suddenly vanished off the face of the earth. The thought excited him terribly.
Spend time with the boys.
So he went further. He imagined that he came to two open drawers and that he could go to either. Last choice.
Oh, I see where this is going. Alright, you're gonna fucking make me feel like a dick.
It barely mattered what lay behind the door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold.
Isn't she hot? Isn't my wife hot? Look at that. That was white everything.
As he wandered through this fantasy world, he began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations.
Okay, I'm not going.
Down one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable. And so in his head, he relived it again. And then again, and again, over and over, wishing beyond hope that it would never end, that he might always feel this free. Sure, there's an answer down some new path. Mustn't maybe. Perhaps if he played just one more time.
I really don't like this. Tell your wife you love her. Love you, baby, look at you.
But there is no answer. How could there possibly be? In reality, all he's doing is pushing the same buttons he always has. Nothing has changed. The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets. The more he forgets which life is the real one.
Whoops. Yeah, I just spilled pop all over my desk. Give me 2 seconds. Keeping that shit in the video. No, keeping it in the video. Because it's fucking, this is raw, this is uncut. If there's lag in the video, there's gonna be my fuck-ups in the video, because I'm fucking hardcore like that. Alright, we're back.
And I'm trying to tell him this, that in this world he can never be anything but an observer, that as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here, watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
Okay. I ain't doing it. Do I?
Chrissy, can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here, he's electing to kill himself? How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself?
Press 5 to question nothing.
Suppose I can't. Not in the way I want him to. But I don't make the rules. I simply play to my intended purpose, the same as Stanley. We're not so different, I suppose. I'll try once more to convey all this to him. I'm compelled to. I must. Perhaps, well, maybe this time you'll see. Maybe this time. And I tried again, and Stanley pushed a button. And I tried again, and Stanley pushed a button. And I tried.
Turn out of 10, would play again, am gonna play again. Alright, that's great. It's good. No, I was asking myself, I was like, what's my purpose? What do? I just sit here and I push fucking buttons all the... Whoa!
Wait, Stanley thought to himself. Am I sure that the orders stopped coming in? How is that possible? They never stopped. Surely I was mistaken.
What the fuck?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, the Atlas was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. The lounge was sublime, a work of art. What was it about this room that, but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. And so he walked through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
Nah, I'm kind of thinking I want to go down the elevator. Yell at me. Do it. Come on. You can do it.
But Stanley didn't want to go back to the office. He wanted to wander about and get even further off track. So now in order to get back, he needed to go, from here, it's, left. Oh, no, it's to the right, my mistake.
Oh, my God.
No, not the right. Why would I have ever said it was to the right? What was I thinking?
Oh, my God.
It's clearly... Oh, dear, would you hold on for a minute, please? Down, right, left, down, left, right. Yep, okay, yes. I've got it now. This story is absolutely, definitely this way.
Is it? Holy shit, this game's laggy. It was never this laggy.
No, this isn't right at all. You're not supposed to be here yet. This is all a spoiler. Quick, Stanley, close your eyes. Okay, we just back to, who am I kidding? It's all rubbish now. The whole story completely unusable. However, rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense, we'll just restart the game from the beginning. And this time, suppose we don't wander so far off track, hmm? Okay, from the top.
Wow. So he just gets all flustered if I, like, don't beat the game? He's just all mad at me?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stastany decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. When Stanik... Wait, what? No, I restarted. I swear, I restarted the game over, completely fresh. Everything should be... Or did something change? Stanley, did you change anything when we were back in that room with all the monitors? Did you move the story somewhere or... Hold on. Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story. It was right here just a minute ago. I know for sure that it's here somewhere. Okay then, it's an adventure. Come, Stanley, let's find the story.
Oh shit, okay, go this way, and then... This way? No.
I'll say it. This is the worst adventure I've ever been on. I can promise you there definitely was a story here before. Do we need to restart the game again? Well, I find it unlikely that we'll ever progress by starting over and over again. But it's got to be better than this. Okay, let's give it a shot. Why not?
No. God damn it, I was having fun.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanis decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Very slow now, for some reason. Hang on, let me just stop and let the game catch up with itself. Come on. There we go.
Okay, yep, it's worse. I might be remembering this wrong. It's possible the story is back where we just came from. Why don't we go back the other direction and see if we missed anything?
Right there, maybe?
Aha! I knew we'd miss something.
What?
The story, here it comes. No, wait, never mind. Not the story. Okay, let's head back the other way.
Oh my god! The fuck is going on?
Now this... Well, I'll be honest, I don't recognize this place at all. Is this the story? I don't think so. I can't quite recall whether believe my story took place in an office building. Is that correct? Do you remember some Saturday? Well, do you know what? Since I've completely forgot what we were supposed to be doing, how about this? You win! Congratulations! I know you put in a lot of hard work, and it really paid off, so good job. Oh, no, I don't feel right about this at all. We both know you didn't put in any actual work for that win. Some people win fair and square, and this was not one of those situations. Okay, I'm getting weirded out by whatever this place is. I don't care what might happen this time. I have to restart.
Wow. Oh my god. This is ridiculous. This whole game is just ridiculous. whole game. Whoa.
All right, I've got a solution. This time, to make sure we don't get lost, I've employed the help of the Stanley Parable Adventure Line. Just follow the line. How simple is that?
Whoa. Okay. Okay. Oh.
You see? The line knows where the story is. It's over in this direction. Onward, Stanley, to destiny. Well, here's a thought. Wouldn't wherever we end up be our destination, even if there's no story there? Or to put it another way, is the story of no destination still a story? Simply by the act of moving forward, are we implying a journey such that a destination is inevitably conjured into being via the very manifestation of the nature of life itself? Whoa. Hang on. That got a bit weird back there. Well, I'd like to apologize. Not sure where I was going with all that.
This is all...
What? I think what we need right now is a bit of new music to lighten the mood.
Fucking kill me.
Wait, cut the music. Go back and look at that fern. Stanley, this fern will be very important later in the story. Make sure you study it closely and remember it carefully. You won't want to miss anything.
Okay.
Wait, but we're back at the office? No. Lion, you do know we're looking for the Stanley Parable, right? The story? Is any of this ringing a bell?
You know, I'm really loving the fact that this game skips a lot. Okay.
You know what, Stanley? I say forget the adventure line. What's it ever done for us?
Well,
we're intelligent people, right? Why can't we make up our own story? Something exciting, daring, mysterious. Ooh. This all sounds perfectly doable. Why don't we simply start wandering in, well, I don't know, how about this direction?
Okay.
Now, yes, this is exciting. Just me and Stanley forging a new path, a new story. Well, it could be anything. What do you want our story to be? Go wild. Use your imagination. Whatever it might be, Stanley, I'm ready for it. Oh, not you again. I don't actually like to veto the line. I'm having any role in our awesome some new news story. No low lines on the monitor rooms.
Okay, we'll just wait for that to go away.
Just standard acknowledges. This should be fine.
How do they expect me to follow this?
a choice. We get to make a decision. From here, the story is in our control. How important, we mustn't squander the opportunity. In fact, I believe I need a minute to think here. Just walk in circles for a minute.
Are you kidding?
Okay. So I know that each door has to lead somewhere, which means that somewhere, the place where we're trying to go, there must be a reverse door that leads here. And that, in turn, means that our destination corresponds with the counter-inverted reverse door's origin.
What?
So starting from the right, let us ask, will taking the right door lead us as to where we're going? And since the answer is clear, by all accounts, the door on the right is the correct one. Another big victory from logic. Come, Stanley, our destiny awaits. Oh, hold up, what's this? The confusion ending. You're telling me that's what this is? It's all one giant ending? And we're supposed to restart the game for eight times? That's really how all this goes? It's all determined? So now, according to the schedule, I restart again. Then what? Am I just supposed to forget? Well, what if I don't want to forget? My mind goes blank simply because it's written here on this thing, wall. Well, you consulted me. Why don't I get to decide? Why don't I get a say in all of this? Is it really? No, it can't be. I don't want it to be. I don't want the game. I won't restart the game. I won't do it. I won't do it. I won't do it. And the time returned. Stopped. Does that mean, did we break the cycle? The whatever it is, it made this schedule. How would we even know? Will someone come for us? Will something happen? So, okay. I guess now we just wait. You know, I suppose in some way that this is a kind of story, wouldn't you agree? I'm not quite sure if we're in the destination or the journey. Though they're always saying that life is about the journey and not the destination. So I hope that's where we are right now. We'll find out, won't we? Eventually. Well, in the meantime...
Oh! Okay! Because, you know, this is... Alright, let me just say it right now. I'm very sorry that it keeps doing this, guys. I don't mean to, like, have it skip. I've been trying to fix it. It's just, it lags and it does that. And I'm really sorry. But I've come too far to stop recording now and try to do it over again. I've gotten to run the smoothest I can. When I'm not recording, all my games run fine. But when I start recording, they just get really fucked up and weird for some reason.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Oh, no, not again. I won't be part of this. I'm not going to encourage you. I'm not going to say anything at all. I'm just going to be patient and wait for you to finish whatever it is you enjoy doing so much in this room. Please take your time.
I like this closet. It's a good closet.
Alright, I don't think he's gonna say anything.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Elevator ride's taking a little bit of time here. Is that the narrator humming along with the song? Down instead, because we were going up. Here we go again. Quite a bit. You can like hear the narrator and shit. Wow. Okay, I guess we don't really go anywhere. Well, that was a fun fucking 4 minutes of a waste of time. It's fine.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. What could it mean? Stanley wondered aloud to nobody. He began wildly tearing through papers on the boss's desk, pulling books off the shelf. Stanley was in such a rush to get through the story as quickly as possible, he didn't even have a single minute to just let the narrator talk. So he relaxed for a few moments. Whispered the calming new age music. Feeling soothed and rejuvenated, Stanley calmly walked forward into the opened passageway.
Okay. Honestly, I don't really feel like doing that. This game is so fucked up. I love it. Oh my god, I love this game. See, I've never played this game. I think I might do a second episode of this after this ending. Like, whatever the hell I plan on doing next, because I know that the more choices you're given, the more you can deviate off your course. And, this game is just loaded with shit like this. There was also the Stanley Parable demo, which I think I might download too. Because people are telling me that it's not a demo. It's not a demo of this game. It's like a completely new addition to the Stanley Parable in the, I guess, in the, like, model of a demo. I don't know. We'll have to check it out together. This game I fucking love.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility. Although this passageway had the word Escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
But it says Escape, so I don't believe you.
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track. At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Oh God. Oh no. Yep. All right. The guy who made this game is a fucking genius. Seriously. The people behind this game literally knew what they were doing. Oh, that's awesome. Whoa.
As the machine whirred into motion and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise, he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever. Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is. Perhaps his death was of no great loss, by plucking the eyeballs from the eye. So he resigned and willingly accepted this violent end to his very short life. Farewell, Stanley.
Bye, guys.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal doors. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly. And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish? When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
So fucking weird. Okay. This is so weird. What are you? Off the clock. Good. Elevator. It's just a bunch of fucking shit. Like, wow. Oh, it's like concept art for the game and shit. This is really cool, man. Warzone. Early in development, movie was an ending where anyone would end up in a battlefield fighting aliens. The action game would become sentient and would wage war against the narrator. We realized shortly after starting to build it, it was far too jokey and on the nose for the tone of the game. Plus, some people interpreted it as making fun of people who like shooters, which was not our intention. It's actually really cool. This is really mind-fucky. This is super weird. Like, really weird. Where do I go? Everything closed behind me. Does it just want me to explore this over and over again? Maybe I go. Do I go in here? I think I might go in here. There it is. Kevin Brighting, the voice of the narrator, recorded dialogue for the entire game roughly three separate times over 2 years of development. These clips are from early takes that were not used in the final game. Oh, if I click on things, it does different things. Okay. Okay, cool. An early version of the app. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, this is all really cool. Well, it looks like this is, I guess, the ending. I don't think there's anything. I think it just puts me in here. Just because. I don't know. Oh, wait. Okay, fun. Cool. What are you? You know what, guys, I think that's it. This was fun. I really enjoyed this game. I'm going to end up playing more of it, though. Let me know if you guys want me to, if you guys want me to record it or not. I'm really sorry it was, like, super laggy and stuff. I tried to get it better, but it just wouldn't work. So, thank you guys for being troopers and sticking it out with me and playing this game. It's the Stanley Parable. It's $15 on Steam. It's definitely worth it. I mean, it's a little pricey, but I honestly believe that it's a good game and it deserves every penny that it gets. This game is really cool, and I like, you don't really find a bunch of games like that, that have the narrator fucking make you feel like shit for not following what he tells you to do. I think that's really cool. I'm gonna look for more endings, I think. But until then, this was super fun, and you guys can follow me on Twitter. I'll put all that stuff in the description below. Leave a comment, you know, subscribe, maybe even favorite the video if you're feeling up for it. You know, the more views you guys give me, the more my channel can grow, and the more I can play these games, because it shows me that you guys support me, and that's awesome. I love you guys, and just thank you so much. Bye!